with the tabs on the side.
Right.
Okay? The non-rebreather is used on a conscious patient, unconscious patient.
Conscious patient.
Conscious patient, they're unconscious, can you use a non-rebreather? Why not?
It's better, like, if you hold it self, it's better.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, can you use this on a conscious patient or non-conscious?
You should be back there.
Can you use this on a conscious patient?
That's unconscious.
Unconscious, so no conscious patient?
You can use it on conscious patients too, but I mean, that's the preferred method of oxygen.
So I go back to my question, can we use this on a conscious patient and a non-conscious patient? The answer is...
10 seconds.
No.
You said you could use it on both, the answer is no. Wait a minute.
It looks like you was going for something else.
Okay, so hold on, watch this. Can you use this on a conscious patient and a non-conscious patient?
Say, what are the reasons that we do CPR?
What is your answer? Yes, what is your answer?
Yes.
What is your answer?
Yes.
What is your answer? Yes, you can use this on a conscious and unconscious patient. Yes, if the person is unconscious breathing, they're breathing? Now think about it, after you do CPR on someone and their heart starts beating but they're still unconscious?
You put them on oxygen.
And what kind of oxygen you gonna put on them? That makes sense. Yeah, so you can use this on a conscious and a non-conscious patient.